This young man nearly died from H1N1, even though he was healthy. Parents feared they'd have to bury their son.
They brought my little brother down from Norfolk twice because they didn't think I was going to make it through the night.
He battled back, but tonight he is still fighting. Good evening, I'm Brandi Peterson.
And I'm Todd Andrews. Rob is off tonight. Chris Decker started off with a headache and fever. Just days later, H1N1 and pneumonia nearly killed him.
Tonight, the college student is recovering at the Madonna Rehabilitation Hospital in Lincoln. Capitol Bureau Chief Andrew Ozaki spoke with Decker and his family. The remarkable recovery is our big story.
Chris Decker should be marching in the South Dakota State Band or hunting deer. But now he's at Madonna Rehabilitation Hospital in Lincoln, trying to build up enough stamina just to climb stairs.
I'm down 50 pounds, so, I mean, I lost a lot of my strength.
H1N1 hit the healthy 22-year-old October 16th. A week later, he was flown to Creighton University Medical Center with pneumonia. One lung was filled with fluid.
At one point, you know, the doctors told my parents that I was the sickest person in Creighton Hospital.
Chris was on a ventilator. Medical staff did everything they could, even placing him in an induced coma. His fever raged to 105 degrees.
And finally, when they said to us, we don't have any more tricks in our bag. If this doesn't work, there's not anything more we can do.
Chris's family and his girlfriend kept vigil at his bedside. At one point, his father admits he thought about who his son's pallbearers would be and the haunting image of Chris struggling just before he passed out.
And Chris just looked at us and said, help me, help me, help me.
Get me out of here.
And that was what I thought was the last thing I was going to hear my son say.
They prayed, even setting up a prayer chain through the Caring Bridge website. Within days, they had thousands of people logging in, pulling for Chris.
We literally did have people all around the world praying for him.
Then a new experimental flu drug called Paramivir became available. Chris was the first person in Nebraska to get it just hours after President Obama approved the drug. But that didn't do anything for the pneumonia, which was getting worse.
The one night when they said he was so sick, just put out a brief post, our family needs time and prayer. And the next morning, he was still alive.
Science would tell you Chris's youth and strength pulled him through. But the Deckers say it was something more.
I think finally, God just got tired of all those prayers and said, you know what, fine, that's what you people want, I'll make him better.
Me too.
In Lincoln, Andrew Ozaki, KETV News Watch 7.
Now the Deckers say they are overwhelmed by the kindness they've received, from getting rides everywhere to someone paying their hotel bills. Chris hopes to leave Madonna Rehab in the next couple of weeks and go back to South Dakota State next semester.